According to the latest news by IRCC, PR will not only be easier but also quicker. So make sure that you watch this entire video because you might be the one getting PR this year. In this video, I'll be covering the latest news on PR by IRCC. Second, I'll be covering who's eligible. And the third one, which is the most important one, is how to book your IELTS. Because right now, none of the websites is working. Because the day this news came, the IELTS websites crashed and they are at the same status right now as well. Welcome back to Bani Abroad. If you are watching this channel for the first time, then I make content on studying and settling abroad, which will give you an edge. So make sure that you hit that subscribe button and hit it right now. So let's talk about the IRCC update first. So starting May 6, IRCC will be accepting applications under three streams, out of which 20,000 applications will be processed for temporary workers in healthcare, 30,000 applications for temporary workers and other selected essential occupations. So these three streams are for all those people who are currently working in Canada, irrespective of the fact if they studied in Canada. Now coming to the third one, 40,000 applications will be processed for international students who graduated from a Canadian education institution. Now for international students, of course, there are a lot of people who would have graduated, but only those are eligible who graduated within the last 4 years and not earlier than Jan 2017. Now these three streams are going to open on May 6th and the deadline is November 5th. But since I mentioned a few numbers, that means it's either that date, November 5th, or when the cap is achieved. For example, for stream 3, if 40,000 international graduates apply by the month of June itself, then even though the deadline is November 5, your application won't be considered. So that's why it's really, really important that you take your IELTS exam if you haven't taken that in the last 2 years, and make sure that you stay till the last of the video because I'll be making sure that you are able to book that. Now let's head over to the eligibility criteria section. So the number first criteria is that you should have completed your program no earlier than Jan 2017. And the education, of course, has to be from a DLI institution. And I don't think that that's going to be a problem because all the international students who come are mindful of the fact that their institution should be DLI recognized. The second eligibility criteria is that your degree, diploma, certificate, that should not be less than 8 months. Again, I don't think anyone would face this problem. Number third point, that you were authorized to study in Canada, that also won't be a problem. And the number fourth criteria is that you should be on your work permit. The number fifth criteria is that you should demonstrate English proficiency, and the benchmark that they have set here is 5. That is pretty low. I think anyone who came to Canada on a study permit would be easily able to pass this criteria because you already gave your IELTS academic and this is not much. It's just benchmark 5. The number 6 eligibility criteria is that at the time of your application, you should be physically present in Canada and also at the time of approval. Now, of course, when you would be submitting your application, you would need to give the proof for the fact that you are residing in Canada, but not the proof that you will be in Canada when you get your PR approval. Number 7th is that you should intend to reside in a province other than Quebec because this is not for Quebec. The rest of the eligibility criteria is pretty simple. It just mentions that you should use the proper procedure and you should satisfy the officer and you should not have anything that hampers your profile. Now for the international student stream, as I mentioned earlier, as you can see on the screen, the cap is at 40,000 applicants. So you need to be pretty quick at this. So now we covered the news, we covered the eligibility criteria. Let's move on to the IELTS section. If you're eligible, then I'm going to tell you a hack which will enable you to book your IELTS, and make sure that you do it right after you watch this video because the dates are getting booked like crazy. Now, as you're aware, I also graduated last year, so I come under this category of international graduate. I am eligible for this, and of course, I would also be applying. So just yesterday, my friend called me up and told me about this. We realized that, okay, we need to book our IELTS general exam as soon as possible. We started looking for dates. We started looking for centers. Of course, there were dates available. None for the paper-based exam, but there were quite a few available for April in Ontario for computer-based. We thought, wow, okay, we'll just book it now. But once we clicked on the date and then pressed continue, all that we could see on the screen was never-ending buffering. And that persisted. We tried for British Council, IDP, and the other exams which IRCC accepts for PI, but nothing was working. And then I went out and we discussed that, okay, we can ask our friends or family in India to book that for us. And she said that she has already tried that, but it's not working. But I could see the dates disappearing, so there had to be something, right? Otherwise no one could have booked that. I woke up in the morning, I called my brother back in India. So one thing I recommend is that you open a private browser, open the incognito window, and there should be no ad blocker on your web browser. So private browsing and no ad blocker, and it was working fine. We went ahead, all the information was filled, but then again when it came to the payment section, it just got stuck, and in the URL there was this error word. So we thought, okay, let's not waste time on this. And then he proceeded ahead, and there was a lot of frenzy, okay, quick. But then I told him that, okay, hold on, let me read what are the payment options, because it was PayPal, and then it was mentioned that you would be able to pay through your credit card if you select this option, but that wasn't working for me. Maybe it would work for you, but if it's not working for you, then on the left hand side you would also find offline payment. You just have to click there, and that's basically payment by Interact. So it's pretty simple. Once you confirm your application, if you have clicked on offline payment, then it would appear on the screen that you need to interact to this email address, and this is the security question that you have to put up, and this is the security answer. And also you have to fill in the message information, your name, your date of test, and your center location. So I just checked quickly if this is a scam or not, but apparently on the FAQ section it was mentioned that, okay, you can also pay through this method, but there was no amount mentioned. And on my PayPal thing it appeared that I have to pay $330, so I just entered that amount and transferred it via Interact. And then there's also the step that once you have transferred the money, you have to click a screenshot of that and send it over to the email ID mentioned. So I'll put that in the description box. So after half an hour or 1 hour, I received this confirmation that my money has been accepted. And then after 2-3 hours, I got a response to my email that we are processing your application. We are aware IDP Australia has informed us that the website is not working, but we are working on resolving it and will process your application as soon as possible. So I will update you on Instagram when I get the official confirmation. This is the way that you can also go about and book your IELTS. And now make sure that you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel, and do nothing. Just open the IELTS booking tab and start booking your IELTS exam. I hope that you are able to book it. Until my next video, take care and stay happy. Bye.